for one. Always wear your seatbelt. Turn down for what? So before you know how to do anything, you want to know how to start the car. Starting a car with a manual transmission is different than starting a car with an automatic transmission. Turn it all the way. And then you don't want to do this, but you can see that if the clutch isn't in, it's not going to start like an automatic transmission car would. So you press the clutch in all the way and then turn it. Let off the key and let off the clutch, and then it's all fine. Okay, to put your car in any gear, you have to have the clutch in. The clutch engages the transmission so that it can come out of neutral and go into gear. That's first gear, second gear, third gear, fourth gear, fifth gear, and reverse. If your car is in any gear, such as first, you cannot take your foot off the clutch pedal without pressing down on the gas pedal. This will kill the car. I'm not going to demonstrate it because it's very bad for the car. So if your car is in gear, your foot cannot come off the clutch unless you are getting ready to work the gas pedal with it. One of the hardest things to learn when learning how to drive a car with a stick shift is when to shift the car. So when to shift the car depends on basically the revolutions per minute, which is the RPM. Most cars with a manual transmission have a tachometer in the car. A tachometer is a gauge that reads the RPMs in your engine at the time. So basically it depends on how fast you need to accelerate. If you're stopped on just a normal neighborhood street and you're just going from a stop to accelerating down the street, you don't have to kick up the RPMs that much. My average, I usually wait until the car gets up to 2.5 RPMs and then I shift. In manual cars, there's also a small light that comes on in the bottom right-hand corner of the dash, and it's a little orange arrow, and it's basically the car telling you, like, it's okay to shift now. Some people don't really read or pay attention to it. It all depends on when you want to shift, basically. The faster you go, so the more miles per hour you have, the higher the RPM is going to be. That's why if you're merging onto a highway or somewhere that you need to shift and accelerate really fast, your RPM is going to go up really high if you're wanting to accelerate really fast. So when you're at a complete stop and you want to go, you're going to press in the clutch and put it in first, that's over to the left and up, and then you have to perfectly modulate how much of the clutch you let off and how much of the gas pedal you put on. So you let off the brake, let out on the clutch while still pushing in on the gas pedal. And when the clutch comes completely out, you can shift again. To shift again, you push the clutch in, let off the gas, put it in the gear that you want it in, and then let off the clutch while simultaneously putting on the gas pedal again. So now I'm in third gear, I want to put it in fourth, so off gas, on the clutch, in the gear, off the clutch, and then on the gas. Really long process. And then for the last time, into fifth gear. So now that I'm coming up to a stop sign, I just press in the clutch, take it out of the gear, and then press onto the brake to stop. if you're driving and you're already going semi-fast, but you come to a turn or a corner that you need to slow down for, but don't have to stop at, say you're in fourth gear, but going around the corner up ahead, you want to go into second gear. Put it into neutral, hit your brakes, slow down for the corner, go around the corner, and then just put it into second gear. That way, you don't have to come to a complete stop every time you want to slow down and downshift. Downshifting is going from a higher gear to a lower gear in order to slow down. So again, an example of downshifting. Taking it out of fourth gear, hitting the brakes, going around the corner, and then putting it into third gear this time because I was going faster. When it comes to shutting your car off, there is no park gear like in an automatic car. So to keep it from rolling on a hill when you shut it off, you can do one of two things. The first is putting on your parking brake, and that will usually hold it on a parking lot or like more of a surface flat ground. Whereas if you're on a steep hill, such as what I'm on now, you can keep the car from rolling by putting it in a gear, so first gear. So just put it in first gear like you would normally do. Keeping your foot on the clutch and the brake at the same time, turn your key to shut the car off. Then you can let off the clutch because the car is off, and then slowly take your foot off the brake. And now the car is locked. The transmission is locked into first gear, and so it's not going to be able to roll forward or backward. I tend to put it in first gear wherever I go because I don't know how well my parking brake can be trusted. You can always tell when your car is in neutral by how much the stick will move back and forth. If you put it in first gear, it's not going to move back and forth very much. But if you put it in neutral, it's going to move back and forth a lot. Because cars with a manual transmission don't have a gear for parking, you need to use the parking brake when you park. Just pull it up, put it back down, you know, put your foot on the brake so your car doesn't roll anywhere, and then just press the button and put it down. And then put it up in your park, and the car won't roll anywhere. To put your car in any gear, the clutch must be in. That's first gear, second gear, third, fourth, fifth, and then reverse. I'm getting here! Sorry, okay. If your car is in gear, your foot must always be on the clutch unless you are driving it with your foot on the accelerator pedal. This is hard to explain, guys. How do I explain it?
I don't know how to drive it.
Tips and pointers!